I don't ever think that we should be accumulating more than what we need, what we can use, and what we can master. I use both Fujifilm systems, which is the X series and also the GFX series. Now, the GFX series is not so much for personal work. I reserve that for my commercial clients. But for other shoots, I'm on the X series. Shoots that require fast action, say maybe I'm shooting sports, or maybe I'm shooting an event where I would have to produce a larger number of images, where I would need to walk around with two cameras for 10 hours a day, 3 days in a row. Whereas for the GFX, I would use it, you know, when we have the whole day to set up, experiment, explore, and at the end of the day, we need that one perfect print. Especially if, you know, we're working with models, we're working with makeup artists, and we're talking about the details of the picture, we're talking about precision. My two main lenses are primarily the 56mm and the 23mm lens. I usually carry two bodies. One would definitely be the 23mm. The other one would change between the 56 or the 16mm. When I'm dealing with a fast changing scenario, I don't always have the time or the allowance to get nearer to my subject. So I like to have a 56 on me, which is a little bit of a zoom. I also like the 23, so it gives the wider scope of the environment. How much do I use the 23? More than 50%. So doesn't that make your pictures boring? The 23 can say different things when you're going in or going far out. You can do street photography with it, you can shoot details with it, you can go really near, you can do macro shots. And then when you do need a wider view, the 23 is great to sort of capture the environment. The 56 in particular has a very beautiful bokeh. I love shooting at it at 1.2. It creates like so much cream around a portrait. I also use it to do street photography, especially when I'm in countries where I'm not allowed to go so near, where I sort of question my social boundaries with people at certain times or on days where I didn't feel so brave to go near people. I would put on the 56 and photograph them from afar, from an observational viewpoint. So the other lenses that I love, actually the 16 1.4. It depends on what sort of a street photographer you are, but sometimes the 16 comes in really handy if you are in a really tight space and you want to capture the entire environment and you want to bring the viewer closer to you. So when it's wider and when you're closer, it makes the viewer feel like you are really immersing them, immersing yourself into the pictures. So I actually went around Japan for 3 weeks with solely the 8-16 lens. And I think it's so extremely challenging, and at the same time, it forces you to understand what distance really means, especially when you're on the 8. It's so extremely wide that you have to abandon your previous thinking of how you would compose and just relook at the whole thing. You know, it just forces you to look around. What you see around is actually what goes into the frame at 8 and not what your sight naturally looks at. If you can only own one lens, it would definitely be the 35mm. It's very strange because I started out with the 23 and the 56. You can actually skip the focal length in the middle, which is the 35. But at the same time, the 35 can actually do almost everything. Go near, create enough bokeh, pull back, capture the entire scenery. It captures the perspective of what you see with your eyes. There's hardly any distortion. If you're into like sort of the kinfolk look, if you are into the Instagram squares, I think that's where the 35 would give you a lot of leverage for doing like lifestyle shots, for shooting objects, for shooting landscapes, for photographing people. So if I only ever buy one lens, 35 would be my go-to lens. There are two main bodies that I rely on, which is the X-T and also the X-Pro. I was on the X-T2 for the longest time since the day it came out in 2016. So when I embarked on my journey as an expert photographer, the X-T2 convinced me to Fuji because it reminded me of the old cameras that I used from my father's dry box. The X-T3 is my go-to camera. I always have this in my bag on professional shoots. For work, for sports, even for street, you know, I can close my eyes and use the camera without needing to ask myself where is this function or what. It doesn't feel like a digital mechanism. It's a little bit like wearing a watch with the clock face of hours and minutes as opposed to when you wear a digital watch. It's a completely different feeling. The essence of photography is stopping time. I would like to feel that flavor of antiquity despite it being a digital object. That's the reason why I'm so drawn to the X-T2 and subsequently the X-T3. The new additions to my dry box cabinet obviously is the X-Pro 3. You must have seen the Fuji Girl series that I did. Three of the series actually uses the X-Pro 3. When I'm photographing for myself, I use the X-Pro 3 more. It's a more fun camera, it's less serious. It also looks very cool. So the main difference, on one camera you can directly turn the ISO dials, and on the other camera you actually have to lift it before you turn it. So they both have a high per second frame rate, but intuitively you would slow down more with the X-Pro 3 just because of the way you handle the mechanisms. It makes you photograph more like film, if I'm saying it correctly. I started shooting for a very long time with just the 18-200, and with that lens I was having fun composing, running around, shooting what I feel like shooting, you know, being happy with photography. And I think that's extremely important. You really immerse in the frame, you immerse in the beauty of the light, and from there you pick up that passion. That passion drives you to want to learn and go forward. So don't worry about like, oh, I'm not having this lens, or I think I missed out on that lens. Of course they're not the same thing, but you don't need everything to be a good photographer. You just need to know how to work the gear that you already have. So with this whole COVID situation, I have been allowing myself to take an aesthetic break. I had plans to rejuvenate my website and look through the 10 years of archives of photographs that I've taken. It reminded me of the time that we're just free to roam around and we take things for granted. You know, you could go traveling just by clicking the button and buying an air ticket, and there you are on the other side of the world. These photos make me realize how privileged the last decade has been without having to worry about a virus coming to invade our lives. There are times where photographers go on a lull period, and that's completely okay. You don't have to be pressing the button all the time. I know some people are thinking, oh, since I have nothing to photograph, maybe I'll photograph home, I'll do a home project. That's awesome actually. But at the same time, if you're hanging around the house and you see a lovely moment, immerse in that reflectiveness, it's no longer just about pressing the button.